a resume of certain important aspects of the former video. Sufficient conversion of degenerated agricultural soils into carbon agroforests would provide unprecedented amounts and quality of organic and healthy foods, including fish and meat, this for unprecedented low prices. Further, conversion to carbon agroforest also would provide all other human needs, including superior fuels and abundant as well as renewable energy, and would make fertilizers non-essential and in fact redundant. Differently then with solar and wind energy sources, carbon agroforests are able to produce energy according to demand, pretty much like a generator can. Very importantly, conversion of agricultural lands into carbon agroforest prevents, reverses soil degeneration, or rather regenerates soils and leaves them more fertile than ever. Soil degeneration is a not sufficiently recognized massive and increasing factor for an unforeseen and dramatic increase in carbon dioxide in the atmosphere now and in the near future. This is so, and will be so, independently if you think this is bad or good. Consumers that prefer to eat soy or soy products, dairy or eggs and or chicken meat, over other foods, still contribute to soil degeneration, as well as to soil degeneration-related carbon emissions, and still contribute to poor people across the world missing out on foods and materials, this because of the prices not being accessible to them. Those who want to reduce carbon emissions should prefer foods and products provenient from sufficiently present carbon agroforests. Preferring foods and products provenient from sufficiently present agroforests, over all other kinds of foods, is in our opinion beneficial for all for human health and thriving desirable aspects. At this point we end the resume, and start out with the subjects of this video. In the case of sufficient conversion of degenerated agricultural soils and eventually of degenerated forest soils, into carbon agroforests, would make that all by them produced foods would be organic foods, simply because traditional fertilizers and herbicides, etc., will not be needed anymore, and also because fertilizers and herbicides are not really efficient, and rather redundant or even damaging when applied in healthy and mature carbon agroforests. In the sidelines, we inform that there is plenty of evidence that crops from such carbon agroforests, that we call carbon agroforest crops or carbon agroforest foods, and that include all ingredients of standard diets, is the main reason that certain Amazon Amerindians provingly, and by far are benefited by the best heart and brain health in the world, and further also are benefited with the relative absence of degenerative diseases. All this was detected, this in over 10 years of research, amongst those Amazon Amerindians, who go one feeding themselves with these carbon agroforest crops or foods. Further, we claim that close to all 8 billion modern humans still are unaware that such health benefits, as well as that such healthy foods exist. Consensus and business as usual kind of fail to inform the general public about these long-term researched and proven health benefits, and are said that such foods even exist. Fertility and soil structure comes from well-known microbiological activity of the for carbon agroforest typical deep organic soils, similar to the deep Amazon dark earth soils or terra preta soils, that gradually and automatically will build up, improving fertility and agroforestry structure while they build up, this in a controllable way. Tilling of soils, as known from traditional agriculture, is not needed and should not take place in carbon agroforests, just as tilling is not needed and even damaging in healthy natural forests, as it is damaging in healthy Amazon Amerindian traditional agriculture, which typically takes place in natural patterns and involves natural processes. It is obvious that heavy and powerful tilling machines, and machines in general, are kind of burden for all farmers and agriculture, and are a factor in undesirable compaction of soils. In carbon agroforests, all these machines will not be needed the same way, and probably soon become totally redundant in the proposed practices and way of production. Obviously, pests and prevention in general will have to be taken care of, and fully can be taken care of, dominantly or at first by means of plant choices, but also by means of a favorable soil and agroforest structure in combination with microbiologically active healthy soils. Tree and plant choices could be similar to, or learned from how Amazon Amerinds traditionally grow crops in combination with or in close vicinity of trees. This always without the use of costly and eventually not available fertilizers and herbicides, etc. Obviously, there are reasons why the here proposed practices are not massively the case yet. We claim that the main reason simply is that people are not aware of or experienced in the here proposed carbon agroforest practices. The reasons these practices are not general yet are exposed in other of our videos. But what is really more important at this point is how this can be made reality or even the standard. For this, or something similar, to become reality in this series already mentioned or other countries, we suggest that ideally an international group of people, or an international organization, and ideally that would include and possibly prioritize indigenous people, to work and plan together, and first of all crank up and maintain their communication channels, and subsequent cooperation. Once a group is formed, and an action plan is worked out, we suggest A. to use or to adapt the in detail worked out action plan that is freely provided in this channel. 2. B. Invite one or more large and important enough, ideally one or more international companies, to do and or to provide the following list of for success essential elements, this in exchange of for that one company or more companies. Important, essential materials for them to be able to produce or provide eventually very lucrative products, goods, or services. What the group or organization that is related to the carbon agroforest needs from the contacted company or companies, and or from the contacted partner or partners, are cheap mass-produced and rather tiny and or light robots or drones that are able to efficiently harvest, as autonomously as possible, the full height of the carbon agroforests in focus. Keeping in mind that these carbon agroforests could vary in height from 1 meter to as much as 80 meters of height, this also in the course of their development and maturation. Quite different, if not totally different from traditional forestry, trees will be maintained, which certainly will involve regular, rather light prunings. Certain woody parts, and in some cases trunks of the shrubs or trees will be chipped, or even need to be chipped, this preferably so, and for number of reasons, that are presented in other videos, over being logged with typical heavy logging machines. In cases, and part of the time, prunings will be fed directly and fresh to eventual fauna, that can exist of domesticated or eventually of wild animals. Further prunings, and eventually woody chips, will be used in the production of renewable fuels, energy, biomass or materials, as well as in compostation, as well as in the formation of the extremely fertile so-called, and by at least some scientists studied, and rather well-known, Amazon dark earth, or ADE soils. Essential is that production per surface area will become the 100-fold of what traditional agriculture produces of foods, and be composed of a wide variety of materials, products, goods, and services. Former eventually degenerated agricultural soils will regenerate and become extremely productive and exert agricultural, forest-related, and industrial functions, and all of these simultaneously. Such upgraded agricultural areas would in fact replace industrial parks in a much more decentralized way. Yet no industrial infrastructure and traditional road systems, nor any form of pollution or waste products, will neither be required nor be present. This part is presented in other videos. As much as possible in any cases of eventually still needed human activities and operations, these should be preferentially done by people related to the group or organization related to the carbon agroforests, but eventually by humans from all over the world that will operate these robots and drones remotely. This could be somehow comparable with the actual ongoing rollout of driverless taxis in the USA, as well as across other parts of the world. This would lead to very intense agriculture, forestry, and industry with quite limited human participation, at least so inside these extremely productive carbon agroforests. These extremely productive carbon agroforests would become the single most productive and wealth-producing elements of the economies of the involved countries, or even of the global economy. Especially indigenous people, but also all people related to agricultural lands as well as forests, should be aware of this rather unknown potential of the here proposed carbon agroforest practices and derived practices, and all of the challenges that this rather revolutionary approaches and practices eventually will cause, and they also should be aware and very actively involved in this kind of developments, this preferentially from the start out. The best way to be involved from the start is to take the initiatives. The same people and groups related to the carbon agroforests should take initiative and make close partnerships with the mentioned not to the carbon agroforest related partners, most probably or ideally capable international industrial partners. If approached early, with a complete and good action plan, and in an appropriate way, the ideal industrial partners will almost for sure become interested to learn about the project, as well as in partnerships, and ideally in very active and intense participation. After all, such an initiative would be much more than a new agricultural revolution. In effect, it would be more comparable to terraforming, even on another planet, but instead of requiring immense amounts of resources, it would produce immense amounts of resources, exactly where humans live and are in need of these resources. This, amongst many other benefits, including the consequent hard and urgent needed global climate regulation. We are convinced that we, of this channel team and partners, are prepared and ideally placed to assist both sides of this partnership, that is the parties related to the lands and carbon agroforests, as well as to the industrial partners. This is the time to become actively involved and in control. The best time to take initiative is now. If the right people and parties do not start out now, there mainly rest only two possibilities. A. Agricultural lands and forests will go on degenerating, this eventually to the point of becoming irreversibly unproductive. We have sufficient historical examples of this. Or, B. Once that agricultural lands and forests have become degenerated, more traditional, probably mostly industrial parties, independent of those we mentioned during this video, will practice more and probably more radical and degenerative of the same degenerating practices, with the rather well-known consequences, and will dominate and control the situation and much more. Further, not much space, this in many senses, will be left over for others. Possibly the whole process will start out with a not ideal situation, and gradually evolve more into a non-ideal situation, this simply so, because the here explained degeneration would already have progressed for a period of time. As a note, this latter situation is still far from a possible worst case, but then we will not even discuss the worst case. Back to the ideal case. The robots or drones largely should work autonomously. Nevertheless, remote assistance should be provided, especially initially and also whenever required. Robots and drones obviously can and will be intensively deployed, and surely will require maintenance and repair. Such maintenance and repair could or should happen with the intervention of kinds of delivery drones. Such types of delivery drones most probably will be involved in several routine activities. For instance, when one or a number of drones must be transported to another not conjoined tree or another carbon agroforest altogether. While transport of bulky harvest can and should be transported by small and also autonomously and or remotely driven and assisted vehicles, which are able to carefully but efficiently drive in the unpaved carbon agroforests. Adapted cable and or hanging rail transport systems should not be excluded. To develop and explore this extreme potential of carbon agroforests, there needs to be a clear action plan and sufficient unity regarding this action plan. The COP30 international event will take place from November 10th to November 21st, 2025, in Belém, Brazil. This conference, officially the 30th conference of the parties to the United Nations Framework Convention on Climate Change, is focused on accelerating the implementation of the Paris Agreement, and also focuses on key issues like climate finance, adaptation, and the role of the Amazon rainforest. Intermezzo. The in this video proposed Carbon Agroforest Initiative and Action Plan should not only solve many challenges, but should also A. Make all 8 billion living humans thrive, and give them access to quality food, quality of life, as well as life expectancy. B. Have a preventive effect on conflicts and wars. C. Make the Paris Agreement, climate finance, and climate adaptation less or non-essential. D. Increase the role of the Amazon rainforest, as well as better protect it, as well as protect all other tropical and non-tropical forests, and in fact also protect all agricultural lands, this directly as well as indirectly. End of intermezzo. What is needed in the first instance for this initiative to become successful is that after you assisted this video, and in case you like the initiative or information in this video, to please subscribe to this channel, or to leave a comment or a like on this video.